Smoking causes in lawyers or organizations. Hindi mahanap air cost, great insurance premiums, increased accessibility ng mga tao, less productivity, more productivity, at hindi maintenance cost. These are all the costs that can be associated sa smoking na shoulder in some workplace. Then smoking is a workplace concern because it is again occupational health standards. There's an increased chance of accidents like fires, increased health risk, and of course illness and discomfort even for non-smokers as well. Okay, smoking is a workplace concern because there is a law that says that smoking should be regulated in closed workplaces, public land or private workplaces. Sabi ng batas na RA 9211 or the Tobacco Regulation Act na dapat may mga designated area for smoking sa isang enclosed na workplace. Like this, for example, NCCA, I'm sure there is an NCCA workplace here. Sa labas na lang. Okay, so in the old building, this is smoke-free workplace. Diba? Sa labas na sila pwede mong smoke. Then, of course, in framework tobacco control, framework convention tobacco control, on the other hand, is a treaty. It is not a law, but it is a treaty where the Philippines is a signatory. So, the right by the Philippines and the Philippines. So, what does the framework convention on tobacco control say? Ang advocacy talaga ng NCCA, ladies and gentlemen, is a smoke-free workplace. So, it goes beyond RA 9211. Kasi kung ang law natin ay nagsasabi lang na regulate smoking in the workplace, FCPC demands a 100% smoke-free workplace. Ito yung trust ng WHO at ang Department of Health natin ngayon. And but there is no law to back it up yet. So it's more of the department order ng Department of Health natin. Smoking is a workplace concern because kung may mga empleyado tayo na smokers, they need the help of the management or the leadership of the organization because, like I mentioned earlier, smoking is an addiction. So, kailangan nila ng tulong para makikilala natin. And the only way that they can get that help is for the workplace to install a quick smoking support program. Okay, so that's what this is here for. So, again, I have to reiterate, lahat po lang i-provide namin na assistance sa isang organization in installing its quick program ay libre. So, kasi we are funded by the Global Health Partnership of Pfizer Foundation. So, what makes this different from other smoking programs? Because we are not the first and the only smoking program here in the Philippines right now. So, ayaw na po mag-dwell into the details, but we have this PTSD not program framework. Ito po yung ginagamit namin program framework in our workplace health programs. HIV, AIDS man yan, PD, drugs in the workplace, family health in the workplace. Lahat po, ginamitan namin yung ganito. And so far, it has provided us with really good results. So ito rin po yung gagamitin namin program framework for our smoking support program. And another thing that sets this apart from other smoking program is we focus more on the support systems. So, never mind kung walang ganun workplace na i-declare na totally smoke-free or designate na tayo ng smoking area. In the end, ang gusto talaga namin i-address ay bigyan na kautulang support yung mga gusto mag-quit. So, sa akin ako po rin yung support na yan, that is what we are here for, tutulungan namin yung organization mo to build up the network. Ano ba yung mga kailangan? So, kung kailangan mag-provide ng medical assistance sa pag-utang, we have also this other intervention. Acupuncture is a recognized treatment modality for smoking cessation. So, pag gusto nyo ng acupuncture ng isang pasyente, saan siya pupunta? Okay, so we will arrange that for you. We will link you to which not provided for you. We will link you with the proper organization. Okay, so we're also here to promote alternatives to quitting. So dito lang papasok yung pag-promote ng healthy lifestyle, ng healthy activities, para lang ma-address
school materials kasi karamihan nag-smoke because they're not into work, nag-smoke because they're stressed, and everything po yan sa trabaho, like in the call centers. So we are going to find ways to address those triggers. And so yan po yung nagtrabaho ng kids. So yung project engagement, just to give you a very brief lang idea kung ano yung mangyayari. So once an organization commits to the project engagement, it is a daily pagkakamahan ng level of commitment. Kasi sa for example, na NCCA na gateways, gusto namin yung programa nyo. Gawin nyo kami partner. So what happens next? When you sign the letter of commitment, so that means onboard na kayo. After that, we organize your QPLP. So this is the program management team or the implementing team sa inyong organization. Sino-sino ba yan? Taga HR, taga IT, or whatever department. Then, we will conduct a survey. Eh, kasi kailangan natin ng baseline kasi we will use that for monitoring and evaluation. Kasi we want to find out at the end of the certain period of time kung may nagbago ba. Has there been any improvement? Sa mga mga responders na nakita natin sa baseline, ilan na lang natin nila after 1 year? Baka yung 200. So, there must be something wrong. So that's why we are going to conduct a survey. Okay? And we also want to get a feel kung ano yung gusto ng empleyado. For example, I'm a smoker. Tatanungin ka na yung grupa niya. Anong passing services or support ang kailangan mo from us? So lahat yan lalabas sa survey. Then the rest are all training. Capability building training na po yan. Program management training, the peer educators training, the training for your workers and nurses, etc. Diyan na po yan papasok sa technical assistance provision. Then of course, we need to have a policy approved at the end of the engagement just to institutionalize and mainstream the program. So hindi niya si talaga sa mga credit corporations, very important yung policy. Rather than just practicing, wala kang pinakasulat kasi may tendency na nakakalimutan or nababawa na lang sa wala. Yung champion ng program at yung concept ay tumuha na ang masusunod sa kanya na mawala na rin yung class. So very important. Sa NCCA, siguro kami ng formal na memo. Memo lang yan from the executive director. So sabihin na ganito. And ito yung implementing rules and regulation. Okay. Then of course, service provision will follow. Lahat ng mga smokers na gusto mag-quit yung address na yun ang program. So yan po yung mga partners ng this program. So makikita nyo yan coming from different offices. May meron po kami private sector na participation that's not alike representing the private sector. We have the Shield of UST to represent the academy. The Philippine College of Addiction Medicine. Nam Center, lalo siya pangalan ka na sa Center. This one, yung OSHC is DOLE, Department of Labor, Employment, Occupational Safety and Health Center. Then, of course, the World Health Organization, WHO, Regional Office for the Western Pacific. Okay, so yan po yung face-to-face support program ng PTSD. Like I said, we do not begin to be individuals. So, kung sino man po yung magkakaroon ng interest sa programa namin, you can reach us. I think sa binigay kanila ng program, may very steeper na mayroong contact details kung saan po kami nag-reach. So, what will happen is you get someone from your human resource department or admin department, get in touch with us so that we can partner with your organization. Okay po? That ends my very quick, I hope it's still brief presentation. So maraming salamat for your time.